Hello, today I would like to go over an activity that you can use with your alternately assessed students when you're working on the Social Studies Passport curriculum for Grade 3, which is Communities Around the World. And one way to start the unit or to go through the unit and talk about it in relation to your students is talking about me and my community. And so you can see here, we're going to start off with just the picture, a train system of New York City, which most of our students are very familiar with, mine are in particular. And I'm going to show you as we go through a really great activity that you can utilize whether you are virtual or in the classroom. So the lesson objective is students will create a diagram of them and their surrounding community. So you'll see an example right here. It's called Me on the Map, so we tie in some geography into it. And it goes through your school, your city, your state, your country, and your planet. So it kind of talks about how you are all parts of these other communities and how you are. You start off with yourself and you get into a bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger community, and you're a part of so many different communities. So I really love this image, and I'm going to show you how I was able to modify it and put it into a Jamboard so that you can have your students participate even if you're not in the classroom and you can't cut and paste them to look like this. However, you can also do this if you had some parent participation at home or guardians able to help out your students. So this is something you can also work towards after our activity. You'll see here too is another slide that I pulled from Teachers Pay Teachers. So again, if you need to do this virtually, you can start here and you can go throughout all the different components that your student is a part of, right? So me, then my school, then my city, then my state, then my country, then the planet. So you can kind of talk about all these various different components that your students are all a part of and all the different communities that your student is a part of. So after showing this, I want to share with you also a really awesome read aloud that I found called Me on the Map, and it's on YouTube. It's free. It's a really quick read aloud. It's Me on the Map by Joan Sweeney. So let me play this, just a little bit of it for you to get an idea.
Welcome to Storytime with Miss Melange. The title of our book is Me on the Map, written by Joan Sweeney, illustrated by Chin Lao. This is me in my room. This is a map of my room. This is me on the map of my room. This is my house. This is a map of my house. This is my room on the map of my house. This is my street. This is a map of my street. This is my house on the map of my street. This is my town. This is a map of my town. This is my street on the map of my town. This is my state. This is a map of my state. This is my town on the map of my state. This is my country, the United States of America. This is a map of my country. This is my state on the map of my country. This is my world. It is called Earth. It looks like a giant ball.
So I really love this book. I love this read aloud. So this is something that you can also utilize with your students to tell them and kind of prepare them for how we're going to go into starting to identify them and their various communities and how they are all a part of it and how it's intertwined. So let's go through where now we can go through our activity. And you'll see here, I then broke it down to include first to start off with the biggest component, which is my world. So you can start off with having my world and having some lines. So if you have some students who are able to type or write on the lines, you can also take out some of these lines if you needed. They could describe however many characteristics of their world that you would like them to, right? They can say the name, they can talk about the characteristics on planet Earth, whatever it is. Also, if you wanted your students to just draw or maybe find a picture, you can also have something with outlines that you can do. Being as that we have a Jamboard, we can also go in and we can add an image. And I'm going to go in, add an image by browsing into my files, and I'm going to find the Earth icon that I got from Jamboard, and I'm just going to embed that right there, right? So there might be students that are very familiar with utilizing you know, board maker that you want for your AAC learners, so you can have these icons readily available for your students who might need that. So they can go and they could put that in there, right? So their world is Earth. And if you wanted, again, to have different icons of various characteristics or something they say, you can very simply go into Jamboard and make that, right? So here's my world. Then it would move on to my country, right? Again, you can have your lines, or you can have it open where you can then add an image. If you choose to have a board maker image, you can absolutely go in there and you can find, you know, your United States icon, upload it, and then have it embedded into your Jamboard, right? So there you go. So now you have your planet, your country, and then we move further on, again, into our state. So what are the characteristics of New York State? What did we learn as we were going through that, right? Especially in the fourth grade passports, you talk about New York State very in depth. So we can go through and talk about that, list characteristics of New York State, talk about all the things that we learned about government, as far as deep as you want to go, but it's also a really fun activity for your students to start to see how they're a part of a very, very large community and how it gets to break down into those smaller and smaller, more specific communities, such as my state. So again, you can have your students find a picture, draw a picture, or you can utilize those icons, right, from BoardMaker if that's where your students are at and that's what they need. That is totally fine. You can find your New York icon. They have that, and then you would just upload that, and then they can have that. Or you might want that icon for them to be able to then draw or try to draw on their own, right? Maybe that's a great model for your students. So that's fantastic as well. And then you can continue going through. And then we have My City. So we've been learning so much about our community in New York City. What borough do you live in? What street do you live on? What's close by in your community? Can you draw a picture of that right on here? Can we draw a picture of our street? What does your street look like? Did we talk about the Brooklyn Bridge? Have we talked about Prospect Park? So you can go through and you can talk about all the different characteristics of New York City, which are so many, and such a fun activity for your students to get to be aware of and start to learn about all about their city and all the great things that are in their city. Sometimes too, you might want to talk about living in an urban community. What's the characteristics of an urban community? We have a ton of large buildings. There's restaurants. There's lots of people. We have transportation. So you can have all those things, either pictures of them. You can have your students draw them. If your students are able to type them, you can have them type it in as well. Write it in if they're more comfortable, or find all those pictures, right? Or have a model of a board maker icon for them to copy from. And then finally, their community. Do we want to talk about their school community? What about their home? We want to talk about their families if we're tying it into the passports. Who's at home with them? Who is their community? Do they live at home with mom and grandma and auntie? Who do they live at home with? So we can go in, we can have them list all of the people who live at home with them, and then we can also have them draw it in. So this was a really fun activity for my students to go through and work on. I really loved seeing all the different things that they were able to tell me about their home. We were able to make these in class, so we had a lot of different colors, right? So a lot of them looked like this. I cut out those circles for them to then draw on. A lot of my students were able to write, so I didn't need to print out the icons, but this was a super fun activity for my students to do, for me to get to learn about their families and who was at home with them. So it was great for them to be able to recognize who was in their community and how they were a part of so many different communities. And then as we start to learn about other world communities, for them to start to compare and contrast those things. So I hope you can use this. I hope you get to use the YouTube read aloud. That was fantastic. A great story, Me on the Map by Joan Sweeney. It was a fantastic read aloud that's free and available to you. It's super quick. So I hope you can do this with your kids either virtually or in person. And I hope you have a super fun time learning about your students and they get to learn about you as well.